In this video, we're going to walk through how to configure the Payment Services extension for Adobe Commerce. You'll need to start by downloading the extension from the Adobe Commerce Marketplace. From there, you'll head to the My Downloads page that holds all the extensions you've downloaded. Here, we see the Payment Services extension, with the component name listed. We'll need this information as we install the extension. For the first few steps, you'll need to run commands using Composer. Let's open that up now and navigate to the root folder of your Adobe Commerce or Magento open source installation. Now, we're going to run the Composer commands. The first command is going to update your composer.json file with the Payment Services extension. We will run this Composer command now. When you press Enter, you'll see that composer.json has been updated with the extension. Next, you'll need to update the dependencies. To do this, run the same command, but with the with dependencies parameter. This part can take a bit of time to complete, typically between 1 to 10 minutes. Finally, you'll need to update all the root dependencies, which you'll do by running composer update. This can also take a bit of time to complete, typically between 1 to 10 minutes as well. The next step depends on your type of installation, whether it be an on-prem or cloud instance. If you have an on-prem instance, you'll need to run this composer command and then clean the cache. If you're on a cloud instance, you'll need to commit the changes to the composer.json and composer.log files using GitHub commands. Then you'll push the charges to your cloud branch. Next, check that the 4 payment services modules were correctly installed. If you haven't done so previously, the next step is to configure the Commerce Services Connector. If you're unsure of how to do this, check out our video, How to Configure the Commerce Services Connector. Now that you've installed the Payment Services extension, it's time to onboard from the Adobe Commerce dashboard. When you navigate to Payment Services in the dashboard, you'll see that there are 2 options for onboarding. We'll start with Sandbox onboarding. Use your PayPal account credentials to sign into your PayPal developer account. From there, generate a PayPal Sandbox business account following the instructions on the page. After you've generated your Sandbox business account, return to Payment Services and click on the Sandbox onboarding button. When prompted, use the previously generated PayPal Sandbox business account credentials. After you've followed the prompts, and don't worry, you can enter placeholder information here, you'll complete the Sandbox onboarding. You'll see that you now have the option to enable payment services in the Settings section of Payment Services. In the General area, enable Payment Services as the payment method. From there, you'll customize the credit card field and set up the payment buttons that will be displayed in your storefront. You'll also want to set the payment action for both credit card fields and the PayPal checkout buttons. Next, you'll test your storefront in the Sandbox. Start by visiting your store, selecting an item, and adding it to cart. Your payment option should be displayed on the product page. When you hover over the cart and on the cart page, and when you click the PayPal icon, you should get a pop-up from PayPal where you can enter your Sandbox personal test account username and password to see the PayPal payment experience. If you don't have a Sandbox personal test account, you'll have to go to the PayPal developer portal and set one up following the instructions on the page. From there, select your shipping and place the order. When you return to the Adobe Commerce environment, your order should be visible under Sales Orders. Now you're ready to start with live payments. After you complete the form, your request will be sent to an Adobe team member who will reach out to set up your specific account to process live payments. After the onboarding is finished, click on the Enable Payment Services button. Click on the Enable Payment Services button on the Payment Services dashboard to enable payment services on the website. Then, switch the mode from Sandbox to Production. With that done, you'll be processing live payments.